This weekend, there were a number of key developments in Saudi Arabia. On Saturday, a raft of royal decrees announced limited reshuffle, including the Minister of Economy and Planning, the head of Saudi's naval forces, and the head of the National Guard. Another royal decree established a new anti-corruption commission headed up by the Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman. By that evening, the commission had already rounded up dozens of prominent business leaders in Saudi Arabia, some of them princes, some of them former ministers, and some of them current ministers. The reaction in Saudi Arabia has been largely positive. Many Saudis view this as Mohammed bin Salman making good on his promises to rout out corruption and place all Saudis on a common plane. Mohammed bin Salman is, after all, at the head of the Vision 2030 economic reform program. And transparency has been a huge part of the promises that he has issued to the Saudi Arabian public. However, there is a political side, of course, to these purges. Mohammed bin Salman is placing himself unequivocally at the head of the political, economic, and security affairs of the kingdom. By shaking up the kingdom's existing patronage networks, bin Salman is trying to build out a new system, and he's really banking that he has the support of Saudi youth as he tries to combat some of the pushback from the Saudi elite. What's really remarkable about these purges is that Mohammed bin Salman is changing so much domestically at the same time that he is pushing to reassert Saudi Arabian leadership in the region at large.